Center for Contemporary Art Zamekuje Zdowski is in Warsaw, and due to his position, Warsaw, Poland, in the last few years tried to connect itself with many countries of the former Soviet bloc. I think this is very interesting, not only for Warsaw, but also for Western countries, because coming here they can meet, they can see not only at the very high level of Polish art, but somehow also the interesting production of the last few years of countries that are not so much known sometimes in the art world, in the general art world. We made, for example, an exhibition about Ukrainian art last year, and this year is the time of Romanian art. But we have also another project that we call Redirecting East. This is a project of residencies, art in residencies, and in the last year we tried to redirect part of our residencies toward countries, people from countries of the former Soviet bloc and Arabian countries. So we had, for example, curators from Syria, Afghanistan, Israel, or Kazakhstan, Turkmenistan, Pakistan. And I think this is very interesting because there are countries that are not so far from us, but they are not so well known. And we try to build a network that I think will be useful not only for Poland, but probably also for Western countries. Center for Contemporary Art is a pretty huge art institution. It was, after the 90s, the most important art institution in Poland that was not dealing only with art, but also with music, theater, cinema, of course, mainly with art. For example, now we have three important exhibitions. This exhibition of Romanian art, but also an exhibition of art from Germany called Future Perfect, in which we see the German art scene. It is interesting because German art scene is not done by German artists, they are mainly foreigners because they come from many different countries and mostly they live in Berlin. But it's very interesting to see together artists from, I don't know, Mariana Castillo de Bal that is from Mexico and Cyprien Gagliard that is from France and Armin Lickels that is from Italy, for example. And we have also, in the meantime, this time we have also an exhibition of Marta Rosler, that as far as you know is one of the most important artists, American artists nowadays, that she didn't only show some of her historical works, but she wanted also to make a specific work, a specific project for Warsaw, in which she found nine themes that are interesting for people, not only for people from the art world, but also for normal people that should discuss about them during the time of the exhibition. They are, for example, gender or debts or works and other themes like these. And during the exhibition, in the space due to the devoted to the project, there are discussions going on all the time. I am Italian and I am the first not Polish director of a national Polish institution. How it happened, it was a case, of course, like case of life, but I knew Polish art more than 14 years ago, and I was impressed by the quality of contemporary Polish art that I consider one of the most interesting in Europe nowadays, from the 90s on. So because of it, I continued to, I exhibited many Polish artists in Italy, where I was director, for example, of Galleria Civica in Trento, or later director of Biennale of Carrara. I was coordinator of Manifesta in, when Manifesta was in Trentino Alto Adige, South Tyrol. So in all these cases, I had a relation to, with Polish artists, Polish curators. So when you know, there was a call for the new director of Zamekuje Zdowski, I participated and now I'm here. for the future, I would say, I think we are now in times that are, let's say, very difficult and very important times, because things are changing in Poland too. In Poland, we have to admit, we have still a very large audience. There is a deep interest for culture, not only for art, also for opera, for music, for theater. So still the Polish audience is very much interested in culture, but we see in many Western countries as culture is changing. And the interest of people for the culture, as we know, is diminishing. So we are in front of very important challenges that we are now also trying to experiment here too. I think that more and more the public should be involved into the projects. And we try to do it here mainly with discussions. Discussions that are touching through art many different themes. For example, we are going now to open a new project that is called Laboratory of the Future, subtitled Life After Revolution, in which we are going to investigate all the revolutions that are going on around Poland. Of course, first of all, Ukraine, but also Egypt, also Syria, also other countries. And not only revolution, but also this kind of activism that is present already in many, many, many countries. And to see how it is related with art and how art or aesthetic, the aesthetic part of it is also interfering with the political aesthetic. Let's speak, for example, about the protests in Kiev just a few days ago, in which the square became a kind of stage. The city was, in a way, was normal, but the stage, square became a stage in which, in reality, things happened. So this is also, in our opinion, very interesting and very important to discuss. We will continue to discuss also, not only using, trying also to use some kind of new technologies. For example, we just opened a few months ago a web television. That is a possibility to enlarge the discussion about art, but to consider art as a tool of investigation of the world, of investigation of future.